Today, my topic is conservative force as a negative gradient of potential energy. This topic belongs to mechanics. Or this question may ask like this: prove F is equal to minus grad V or F is equal to minus del V. Here, F represents a force, which is vector quantity. Here, V represents a potential energy. Potential energy is a scalar quantity. To balance this equation, we have to utilize this operator, that is grad. Gradient means it is a del operator which multiplied with a scalar quantity, then the RHS becomes a vector quantity. Here, in this case, when a particle acted upon a conservative force, it moves from a space point x0, y0, z0 to another space point x, y, z, then the potential energy at R is given by, this is the matter which is required in your examination. Here, there is a point at R0. This represents R0, which is a position vector, which is at origin. And this xyz represents R. This is another position vector. That means a particle moved from an origin to some other position vector point. Then, and it moves a certain distance of dr, then the potential energy at R, you have to find out. This is the potential energy at R. This energy is belongs to work done. Okay, work done. Then work done is nothing but energy. Here I have considered it as potential energy. Now the potential energy of the total system is minus of F dot dr. Here work done means force into displacement. The displacement of particle is dr. Then we have to integrate the displacement of the, that means the total potential energy in the system, means we have to integrate from 0 to R. Now we have to express these terms like F and dr like a rectangular coordinates, which are the F bar, which represents a vector. This is I into Fx plus J into Fy plus K into Fz, where I, J, K caps are unit vectors in the vectors concept. Here dr bar is the distance moved by the particle, I into dx plus J into dy plus K into dz, which is a position vector. Now make it dot product of these two expressions, then f dot dr. Now put f value here and dr value here, we get f dot dr is equal to fx dx plus fy dy plus fz dz, because we have to multiply this I value with I value, because I dot I is equal to j dot j is equal to k dot k is equal to 1 according to the loss of the dot product. And if I multiplied this with this, I dot j gives, j dot k gives, k dot I gives 0. That's why I had to multiply I with I, j with j, k with k. Then we get this expression. Now we have to put this equation 2 in this equation. Actually, this negative sign indicates a particle away from the origin is taken as minus quantity, whether that may be potential energy or something. Even in Kirchhoff laws also, we consider it as negative quantity. Now we have to put this equation 2 in equation 1. Then V of R means V at x, y, z, with respect to x axis, with respect to y axis, and with respect to z axis. We get minus fx into dx along x component. This is this is y component and this will be z component, like this. This is equation 3. Now differentiate equation 3 partially with respect to x, y, z. We get fx is equal to minus dou v by dou x, fy is equal to minus dou v by dou y, fz is equal to minus dou v by dou z. Because if we differentiate this equation, then this integration will be cancelled with derivative, then these terms will be cancelled, then fx is equal to dou v by dou x, because this belongs to x component. So like that, then again remaining things will be constant. Then if I consider y, then fy is equal to dou v by minus dou v by dou y. Put the values of fx, fy and fz in equation 1a. We get, we already know f bar is equal to I into fx, j into fy plus k into fz from equation 1. Now I have substituted this minus dou v by dou x instead of fx, then this equation becomes like this: f bar is equal to minus of I into dou v by dou x minus j bar to dou v by dou y minus k cap into dou v by dou z. Now we have to consider, we have to take minus as common factor here, minus of this expression, then these terms will be positive, and consider v. Then here we know del is equal to I into dou by dou x plus j into dou by dou y plus k into dou by dou z. Then I have considered this term as del, then del into v. Here del into v means this, that is called gradient. Here f is a vector term and v potentially is a scalar term, so we have to balance this equation. For that we have taken this del. Then the force is always, this conservative force is always negative sign of the gradient of the potential here. So because that particle moved from origin to the another point, this, that's why we got this negative symbol. That means whenever a particle moves from origin to the other point, then that is taken as negative quantity. So in some textbooks they have written a u instead of v, then that also correct. This is very important for B.Sc students, and now R19 regulation B.Tech students. Okay, this is a very, very important question. Thank you.